back. It's been over 2 weeks since I last uploaded a video, which feels like a really long time. If you're new here, my name is Charles and I'm a photographer based in Los Angeles, California. As you can tell from the title of this video, today I'm going to be sharing with you some of my favorite accessories for the Fujifilm X100V. But before I do that, I did want to kind of share with you guys a little bit about what I've been up to the last couple of weeks and some of the content that you can expect from this channel in the near future. But if you want to skip ahead to the accessories, I put timestamps below for you to skip to. So basically after my trip to Yosemite, I took about a week and a half off from just working and creating content. I just felt really burnt out. It was before that I was working kind of nonstop for months and months, whether it was photographing or filming weddings, editing, or even creating and starting a YouTube channel. And so I think all that stuff finally got to me. So it was nice to just kind of be able to take a break and to reset and relax my mind and just to refresh myself, basically. But I was still taking photos, especially with the X100V. I still took it with me pretty much just for day-to-day stuff or things that I wanted to document. And so I've still been taking photos and stuff like that. I've been thinking about what to create as far as this YouTube channel. And I actually picked up a new camera along the way as well. I got the Canon QL17 G3. I'm really excited about this camera. It reminds me a lot of the Fujifilm X100V in terms of the size and how it has a fixed lens. I got my first roll back, and so I'm really excited to share that with you guys and do kind of like a first impression with this camera in case any of you guys are interested in picking something up like this. As far as what to expect for future videos, I'm definitely going to be doing more videos with the X100V. It's my favorite camera to use and I use it the most out of all the gear that I have, so expect more videos regarding that. I'll also be doing more videos on the Canon QL17 and even the Canon A1, another film camera that I have. I'm still a beginner film photographer, and so I'll be experimenting with different film stocks and even how to expose for film. It's kind of cool for me to document how I am right now as a beginner and to kind of see how I grow. And hopefully you guys are able to learn a thing or two as well from that. And so I'll be doing a mix of, you know, digital photography and film photography. And I eventually also want to share a little bit about the wedding industry. My main job is being a wedding photographer and videographer. And so I think I have a lot of knowledge regarding that field. Eventually I want to talk more about that and do some tutorials and some tips for those of you who are interested in becoming a wedding photographer or even a videographer. So if you're interested in those things, feel free to subscribe to my channel. So let's talk about accessories. The first one that I want to talk about is the screen protector. Now I know that this isn't the most exciting or the coolest thing to buy for your camera, but I feel like out of all the accessories that I'll be talking about in this video, this is the one that you actually need and should get. When I got my X100V, it actually had a small crack on the top right corner of the screen. A little backstory on how I got this camera. I bought the Ricoh GR3 for $500. And when I decided I wanted the X100V, I found somebody online who was willing to trade cameras with me basically. And all I had to do was add an extra $200. He was selling it for really low price. Because of the small crack on the screen. And so essentially I got this camera used for about $700, which I think is a great deal, even with the small crack. It hasn't really affected the performance or anything like that. I do wish that he put on the screen protector before he dropped it or however it cracked. But yeah, I think definitely get one. It's really cheap, and so you will not regret it. Second accessory that I have and recommend is a camera strap. Now I know that everybody has different preferences, but I personally love leather camera straps. I think that they're really stylish and I love the look and feel of it. The one that I have is from a company called Clever Supply Co. I'm not sponsored by them or anything like that. I just really love their products. My favorite feature about this camera strap is the fact that it also has a quick release system from Peak Design. Sometimes I just want to be able to quickly take off a camera strap and quickly put it back on, and so I felt like this was perfect for me in terms of aesthetic and functionality. The one that I got retails for about $140 in US. I did find out about this from a photographer named Benj Heish. And so if you go to his YouTube channel, I think he's actually done a review on it. And I think he also has a discount code, which is, I think, 20 or 30% off. So you were able to save some money by using his discount code. The length that I got was 40 inches. And for reference, I'm 5'7". And so you can see here how long it is for me. And you can kind of go off of that depending on your height. Another thing that I love about the quick release system is that I'm able to use this camera strap for multiple cameras as long as I have the Peak Design anchors. And so it's really convenient for me to be able to just basically have one strap for multiple cameras. There's also a cheaper option called the minimal anchor strap. And basically the difference between that one and the one that I have is that mine has that extra padding on the neck. And so if you want to save some money and you don't care about that, that's a great option for you. The third accessory that I have and recommend is a lens hood. I got mine from Amazon from a company called Hoagie. I'm not sure how to pronounce it. Honestly, everybody online says it differently. But yeah, I got this from Amazon for, I think, about $40. I mainly got the lens hood for the aesthetic and just to add to the look of the camera, but it does also help minimize lens flares. It does come with a 49 millimeter filter adapter and a lens hood. I'd say that it matches pretty well in terms of the color of the body. The X100V is weather sealed except for the lens. And so when you add that filter adapter, and you add a filter on top, that's what makes the body fully weather sealed. The biggest thing that I like about this lens hood is how easy it is to put on. Other products like Square Hood, you have to screw it on, and I'm not really a fan of that. With this one, you just basically need to twist it until it's centered and it's tight. Now, there are a couple of cons with this lens hood. Number one, I read online that basically when you use flash with it, it creates like a shadow at the bottom of the frame. I personally haven't used flash with this camera and I don't think I plan to, or if I do, I'm probably gonna take off the lens hood. And so for me, it's not an issue. Another con that I read online is that some people were having a hard time centering their lens hood when they had a filter on. For me, I personally haven't had any issues. I've been using the Black Pro Mist filter and it's been fine for me. I haven't had any issues in terms of centering the lens hood, and so make sure that you're aware of that before you buy. A third con for me is that it doesn't come with a lens hood cover. It's not that big of a deal, but I wish that it had a cover so that way dust and stuff wouldn't get on there. But again, it's not that big of a deal for me. The fourth accessory that I have and recommend is a Black Pro Mist filter. On Amazon, it costs about $45 and I got the 1/4 version. And what this filter essentially does is that it softens the image and takes off that digital sharpness that you sometimes get with these digital cameras. And it also blooms the highlights. And so it's very preferential. Some people love it, some people hate it. I personally like it, especially during nighttime where you really get to see those highlights bloom. I'll probably do a video on this in the future, kind of showing you some examples of what it looks like during the daytime and the nighttime, and probably even comparing it to the CineBloom. I have the 10% version, and so it'd be interesting to kind of see what the differences are between those two products. And last accessory that I have and recommend is a shutter button. There's a ton to choose from online. I got mine from Amazon. There's different colors, different textures, different prices. I got mine in a silver and black colorway from a company called JJC. It came in a 2-pack, and I think it was around $14 or so. I will say that sometimes it has kind of unscrewed. I don't know if this is normal or if this is just specifically from that company, but luckily I haven't had any issues in terms of losing it. And plus it's nice that it comes in two, so it does in case that you do lose one, or if you want to use that in another camera that you have. To be honest, I don't think you necessarily need this. It's just nice in terms of, again, adding to the aesthetic of the camera, and it does kind of feel a little nicer when you press on the shutter button, but yeah, it's just more honestly for the aesthetic to me, at least. So those are five accessories that I own and recommend for the Fujifilm X100V. I've linked all these products down below, and most of them are affiliate links. And what that essentially means is that anytime that you click on that link and you decide to purchase that product, I do get a small commission from it at no extra cost to you. So full disclaimer there, if you want to check out more of my work with the Fujifilm X100V, feel free to check out these videos. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. See you guys next time.